It is Monday again, and I'm just going for it. I have decided that I want to try my hand at vlogging. So that's what we're gonna do. I've worked out, I've showered, I've actually put on some makeup today. I had breakfast, some little egg bites that I found at Costco, and half a honey nut squash. I had never heard of that before, but also found that at Costco, easily cooked it in the microwave, had it with some nut butter and honey and a little cinnamon sprinkle. It was really satisfying, that breakfast as a whole. Perfect for after my workout on the tonal, where I was working my cheeks and my obliques. I didn't make that up. That was what the workout was called. So now I'm all set. I have my coffee. I have a little caramel. You say caramel or caramel? I think I say both depending on what we're talking about, but I have a little caramel Stroop waffle that I found at Aldi last week. Let's try it together. Fortunately, my mug is too big to do the thing where you sit it all the way on top. That is good. It's like not overly sweet. And let's do the oh yes. Oh yes. I don't know how you feel about like black coffee and like a sweet something to go with it. But I've said it before and I will say it again. It's just a glimmer for me. I don't know if it makes me think of my grandpa every time, because the man loved coffee and he loved to have like a donut, or in his case, I think the bear claws were his favorite, possibly a Danish. But one of those. So anytime that I can kind of treat myself, I don't know, I get a glimmer and I like to think that I'm enjoying it for him. So now it's time to get some work done. I'm gonna go through my calendar for the week, go through my to-dos. I'm gonna do a little bit of a brain dump and just get myself set up for success. Voila! Soup. Some leftover challah bread that we found at like a local market. Remind me, if you want to know, where the best challah I have personally had has ever come from. Sadly, it comes from another state. But this one was really good in a pinch because, frankly, I don't know what it is, but broccoli cheddar soup. Oh no, I do know what it is. Gosh, my counters. Everything in my kitchen is dirty right now. I cooked like a full Sunday roast dinner yesterday, and then I cleaned all the dishes but didn't quite have the energy to finish things up. It's on the to-do list. But my mother-in-law makes a really killer broccoli cheddar soup, and she always serves it with this challah bread from a bakery called Loafers near where they live in Pennsylvania. And you know, I'm not saying it's super authentic or anything like that, but it is very light and fluffy, and it's just some of the best, like I said, challah bread that I have personally ever had. And when I think of broccoli and cheddar and soup, I always think of challah.
That is a wrap on me recording a podcast episode all about all the things that you track and observe according to most modern fertility awareness methods. I am a certified fertility awareness method instructor, and I've been using it for almost 10 years now. Basically, it just comes down to menstrual health and empowerment is a topic that's very near and dear to my heart. So much so that Company B that I referenced earlier, that is really what that company's whole agenda is that's what we're here to do. So we've recently started a podcast to have another avenue to talk about some of these things and hopefully get some new eyeballs on our products and offerings. So time to turn off my microphone. I don't really understand this thing because, like, I turned it off, but the light stays on. So I don't really know if this actually changes anything. I'm sure it does in the actual audio quality when I'm doing these calls and interviews. But it's stuff like that where I'm just like, does it really matter? No, I know it does. I know it's important. So yeah, you can see it back there converting the meeting recording because I'm the one that will have to turn around and produce it. But now it's time to get up, get my shoes on, grab my bag, throw a book in there, make sure I'm warm enough because it's sunny out, even though it's not that warm out. But my child probably wanted to go to the playground after school. So need to be prepared for that. I want to take this book that I'm reading, God Killer by Hannah Kaner, with me to the playground, because sometimes when there aren't like other parents there for me to chat about, my kids just running around, I will try to get a few pages read, you know, like read a line, look up, check where they're at sort of thing. But I got really excited because I was like, oh, like a lot of times I try to pick up hardbacks for this reason just because I can be a little rough on books. But I was just like, oh shucks, like I'm gonna put this in my bag, like I hope I don't beat it up so much. But then I remembered that this came in the mail and I finally opened it up this weekend, but it's like a padded book like sleeve. I guess you could also put an iPad in it, but look how pretty it is. And I just wanted to share this moment of joy that I was having from getting to use it for the first time. It's so cute and pretty.
Into community and check in with your people and check in with each other and get a group going to support your mental health. It's really a lot better when we are with each other than trying to solve all these problems on our own. You saved me again, buddy.
That's Midbard.
All right. Got some work done. I've had some lunch. As you can see, I'm all cleaned up, prepared to go out in the world today. I'm watching my dog peek underneath the fence at our house because he's probably wondering, like, they left. Why is mom's car still there? It's a very cute thing that he does. His little pink nose sticks under the fence when he knows that we're, leaving, which is very sad, and coming home. But anyway, I digress. I am about to run those errands that I mentioned. I'm going to head and pick up two books. One is at the library and one is at our independent bookstore in our little downtown area. Luckily, both are within walking distance from each other, so that's nice. And then I'm going to head to Target because I'm having FOMO about some things and I need some new underwear, to be very honest. So we're going to do that. And speaking of FOMO, since I'm going to a bookstore and I'm going to Target, I'm probably going to do a little peruse of holiday themed books. I don't love the idea of like holiday kind of rom-com books. They're not rom-com books, like aren't really my wheelhouse, but I feel like I want like one really good one. But to be honest, I want one that has more to do with like the winter solstice or just like winter season and possibly has some magic or witchy vibes. I don't know if such a book exists. I should probably ask BookTok, but that's where my head is at. So I'll probably do why wouldn't you do a browse when you're going to the bookstore, right?
Good.
All right. Mission one, complete. Got the books, got the goods. I've made it to Target and I've realized I only have about 20 minutes to get in and out, which I feel like is a good thing, like a speed round. There are a couple things that I like actually need, like for dinner tonight, and I knew I could get them here and I just happened to also want to come here. But I feel like having a time constraint is good because, I don't know about you, but I feel like the amount of time I'm allowed to spend in Target correlates with like the more money I end up spending. So I don't shop at Target that often, just sometimes it's the place where they have the thing that you need. So we're gonna go in there, we're gonna get some things, and then we gotta get home because I'm supposed to be on a call in about 45 minutes. I would do a little haul since I did take you on some errands with me today. We'll start with the books. These were the two books that I was really headed out for. One was Against the Loveless World and the other one was A Study in Drowning. I was able to snag this one from my library, which was super exciting. And these are both books that I fully intend to read. Well, this one probably next so that I can send it back to the library. And this one I will definitely be reading, prioritizing to read before the end of the year. And then, much to my surprise, I did manage to find two holiday-themed books that sounded like the right kind of heartwarming, cheesy, that weren't necessarily like your traditional, just like boy meets girl kind of story. But I'm going to save these to talk about more in another video, but just know that I will share, and I was pleasantly surprised. And at Target, the real reason I went there was because I needed some more underwear. So success. And I felt like I needed a copy of this. Like I said, I was having FOMO about it, and my record player, I love that thing, and it just doesn't get enough love. So I'm trying my best to pick up more records here and there are actually things I listen to regularly, and I'm pretty sure this still is my favorite Taylor Swift album. So I feel like I needed to have this because I know it will get listened to a lot. And then other things that I did also get some buns and some french fries, frozen french fries, because we're having some friends over for dinner tonight and we're making burgers. So we're keeping it easy for everybody. And I remembered the things I actually went there for, which, you know, I'm proud of myself for that. And then some things that I didn't necessarily need, but I'm going to be happy that I have them. One is I just went ahead and bought a can of the gingerbread whipped dairy topping. Look, I love to eat vegetables. I tried, you know, but sometimes you just want a little bit of the seasonal funness. Like I'm limiting it to like the one can. We don't need all of them. This one sounded the most fun and I needed to do it. So I checked the expiration date where it's like, well, I could buy it now to make sure that I get some. And then like after Thanksgiving, which is only a week and 2 days away from when I'm filming this, like we can bust it out and go to town, and I'll be really glad I already have it and I don't have to worry about it later. So, and then I couldn't resist. I kept thinking like, well, maybe I can make some of these like mug, what do they call them? Mug huggers. But instead I just got some of these because I know my daughter would think that was super fun.
But I also know that this will be really great on a cup or two of coffee. And they're just so cute. I mean, look at them. Again, like, these are, you know, part of that 80%. Like, these things exist in the world. I don't know where else I was going to find something like that. I love the idea. So I was like, well, I'm going to get one because I know my daughter would like them. But then I was like, who am I kidding? Like, I would have severe FOMO if I couldn't also try that. And then my husband can do it. We just have a nice little moment because I think I've already told you how much I love just a cup of hot coffee and like a little sweet treat with it. I just love it. And then I snagged a couple little crafty things. Those are the kind of things that my kid likes to do, so we can make some ornaments and maybe she can give them as gifts. She can make her own little like gingerbread decorations. Again, like some little Santa gnomes. But again, like, she likes making these things every year, and then she gives them to like grandparents and aunts and uncles and as gifts. So I'm all for that. And then we got, at least in our house, the requisite set of seasonal window clings. My daughter loves to do this, and who am I to prevent her from, you know, taking some ownership of putting up a little bit of festive decorations and just living in the season? So I try to get some of these for every, you know, season or major holiday because she just really enjoys the activity. So yeah. And then she's got this little guy. I think he could go in our, you know, Christmas countdown calendar thing. She was just really cute. And then we got some holiday Hershey Kisses, again, mostly for the countdown calendar, so it's not like a insane amount of treats. Like, these are for a few of the days, and other days we'll put in activities or other sort of special things. Like, these are for just some of the days. I don't really like to do candy every day, but one of the days there will definitely be one of these cute little Christmas ingredient jars in there, and I'm gonna set up a little Christmas potion making station for her. They sell these at Halloween too, and they are honestly, I'm sure, supposed to be for decoration, but I open them up and make sure she can get the stuff out of them, and I make her little like ingredient cards or just let her go to town. But they have all these cute little Christmassy ones, and so I bought these, and I put a link to the Canva file that I made of the little kind of like potion, the made up holiday potions that I use these as the inspiration for. If you wanted like a little bit more of a guided activity, like if you've got your hands on these or you find some similar ingredients, like, parents, I know how hard it is sometimes to find entertaining things to do with our kids. So I just wanted to share the little file PDF, print it out, cut it up. And then you can make a little potion station for your kid too. And if you do and they have fun with it, I would love for you to tell me, because I'm sure my kid's not the only one who loves to make potions. And if you ever want to know some of the other things that I've had for years that help facilitate easy potion making activities, let me know and I'll be happy to share that information, because I have some good ones, some go-tos. And I think that is it. So now I'm going to clean all this up, hide some of it, because obviously the kiddo's not supposed to see most of this yet. And then I'm going to clean up a little bit, because like I said, we are having people over. They're close family and or family friends, so they're not super concerned with the quality of our house, but it'd be nice to clean up some of the clutter and maybe wipe down the counters. That's what I'm thinking. And so, yeah, the kiddo and my husband are at the playground right now. That's usually our usual after school ritual. And we're trying to do it for as long as we can before it gets, you know, a little too cold or a little too dark early on to do it. Because, man, an hour of just running around with your friends after school is just, I mean, from watching her play every day with these little friends that she's made, you know, since kindergarten and now into first grade, it's so sweet. Just watching her do it, I know it's like one of the highlights of her day when she's able to do it. So when they get home, it'll probably be snack time, and then we're gonna hang out, we're gonna have our friends over, and then I really, really want to be able to sit down and read more of God Killer. I am really enjoying it so far. I haven't talked about it that much. But I'm almost 100 pages in, and I mean, I'm really enjoying it. I am curious. Like, we're still in, like, the setup portion for whatever adventures are going to continue. They seem to be, like, just leaving on, like, the full-fledged adventure that's going to occur in this story. So there's a lot that could happen. I don't know how it's gonna go. But yeah, I will give you an update on that later on as well. Right? That's what we say? Yeah. Updates to come. That would have been the easier way to say that. Workout, done. Breakfast, done. Scroll for a little bit to make sure that we're up to date on just world events, done. And then luckily my mom showed up to drop off some stuff from my dad, and that kind of jostled me out of that scroll. So then I was like, ah, I need to get up. I need to get my coffee and get down to my office. So that's where I'm at now. It's time to get some work done. I plan on doing some more filming today, which I'm excited about. That will be fun. I have some bookish content. I have the one and only gift guide that I really want to make. In my head, I think it sounds super unique and a fun one to do. Yeah. So more to come on that. Yeah, let's have a day. Molly, it is bright in here. I'm not complaining. We like natural light, at least where we live. It's actually the amount of natural light our house gets is one of the reasons we love this house so much. One of many, but because our house faces directly east and directly west, we always at least know we're gonna get a good amount in the morning and the evening. The evenings in the winter, not quite as much as, you know, in the summer, but what are you gonna do? I have this is my breakfast of the week, my honey nut squash nut butter, honey cinnamon, and my egg bites. It's just, for someone who not always, but has been struggling with food and just making decisions around food, this has really been helpful. And especially I find as I've gotten older and like there's just more stuff on my plate, so to speak, knowing, like having just like healthy, easy button options is really helpful because I know they say it for babies all the time, but it's the same for you. Like, fed is best. I am a certified health coach and I help people have better periods. And I want you to eat things that are gonna be good for your hormones and good for your health. But here's something that a lot of these, you know, hormone health coaches, menstrual health coaches don't say is that honestly, just like eating in general, making sure you're eating regularly, that's more important than making sure you're following some chart of cycle phase specific foods all the time. Protein, fiber, fat, complex carbs, like just try to make sure you're getting those macronutrients and you're gonna be good. Your hormones are gonna be happy. Yes, there are certain ingredients that you can like, you know, tie in at certain phases of your cycle to help your body like optimize what it's supposed to be doing, but those are just added bonus. They're just going to help. If you're eating mostly whole foods, and I'm not perfect at that, which you will see, like, let's keep it real. We humans invented stuff. it's okay to enjoy it sometimes. You're gonna be good. But the point is, like, 80-20, 70-30, and it can be, you know, an ebb and flow sort of thing. It's real life, and you're gonna be okay. So yeah, I'll forewarn you now, there's gonna be some period and cycle and health talk sometimes, because in addition to just reading and enjoying talking about the things that I'm doing or enjoying, that is a big part of my life. So hope that's all right with you, and if it's not, oh well, this might not be the spot for you. But also the older I get, the more important I think it is to realize that if you have a period, you are a cyclical being, and it just gives you a little extra tie into nature and the seasons and the cycles of things, and it doesn't have to be a bad thing. So that's all I'll say on that for now. I'm gonna eat my breakfast, and then this morning I'm just gonna go ahead, after all that hemming and hawing yesterday, I've decided I'm just going to dust my book, my little cozy corner. I'm going to clean it out, and I'm going to just at least decorate that for the holidays. I'm just going to start with that and choose the things out of our assortment of decorations that I want there. I can always swap them out later, but then at least it will make me happy. I'll be ready to film in there, and I can do some other stuff. So that's what I'm going to do this morning. And then I know I have some job stuff to do with HR operations, payroll sort of things. I know, so fun. So we're gonna get that done today. And yeah, hopefully I'm gonna finish God Killer today. That is high on the to-do list as well. Really old and crumbly. Let me think about this. I accidentally put the one nail too far forward. It was coming through the molding and now it's bent, so I have to go get another one. Satisfied for now. There's definitely a few things missing. Like, I think there needs to be something like in this space, and obviously like that's calling for a little Christmassy something. Maybe I have a little bottle brush tree or something somewhere. There'd probably be a few more books in here. This is my like usually my active TBR section, like, and it shifts as my mood changes, but you know. And then probably something behind that photo or something underneath the photo. I don't know. But it's a pretty good start. It's a pretty good start, I think. So, to be continued. That's what I'll say. To be continued.
There's a bunch of vintage Santa Claus. It's so cute. I like those. Ooh. It's a bell. That's cute. I like that. This one says 1983 on the top. Oh, that's so pretty. If I could just move in, like, I could pay rent and live in the corner and be happy. The sun was shining, the leaves were falling, and there was one thing that's been on my mind a lot lately.
Good morning. I did not do a very good job vlogging anything this morning. It's already almost 10:30, but here we are. And it was husband had to leave early for work, so it was just mom getting the kiddo ready for school. And I came back and I read more of God Killer because no, I did not finish it yesterday despite my desires to do so, but now I only have about 40 pages left, so I think I can do that later today. I've read a little bit more during breakfast, and then this is just, I've decided, like, this is the weekend. We're cleaning things and decorating for the holidays, and so I started doing some of that this morning. I was reorganizing some things in my daughter's room, removing some things to go in the basement to see if they qualify for what I like to call the out of sight, out of mind test. Like, if she doesn't ask for it for 3+ months, it's probably safe to donate it. And if she does, then that's okay. We'll put it in one of the baskets downstairs for, you know, things when we need something novel, we pull that out of the basket. But anyway, I decided I needed to go grab a few more things because I really just want some more garlandy things. Like, I want more greenery. Because as much as I want to go cut down a real Christmas tree every year, because that's what my parents and we, like, always did. They still have a fresh Christmas tree every year. Oh no, I think last year was the year they finally went and got a fake one. But up until last year, that was just something we always did. But my husband does not like the cleanup aspect of it, which is okay. I understand. but that's how I like my home to look. Like, I want to bring the outdoors in, very wintry, because to me the season's more about the season than it is necessarily about a certain holiday. And so I like to bring the evergreen into the home. So I really want to get some more garlands, and I really want to kind of set up like our coffee hot cocoa area. I want that to be festive and set up because I know my kid loves hot chocolate. This is the one and only time of year that I really, like, have the strong desire to put stuff in my coffee. So I wanted to get a few things just to make that, give it a little oomph, give it a little zhuzh, if you will. But now I have to go pick up some Girl Scout stuff because I volunteered as one of the troop moms to do something this season. So I got to go pick all that up, and then I'm going to run a few more errands before I have to jump on a call, and then hopefully get some work done, because then the day's gonna be over and we have plans this evening. There's a school fundraiser. It's gonna be the first time we ever go to Chuck E. Cheese, or as my daughter has been mistakenly calling it, and now we all just think it's funny, so she's running with it, but Chunk E. Cheese. My husband and I are laughing because, like, we haven't been there in 25 plus years. It's for a good cause, and the grandparents said that they would come too so they can help make it more fun, and when I inevitably get overwhelmed, like, they can take over. So that's where we're at today. I need to go pick up some mugs too. I ordered some very festive Christmas mugs because I only had two, and that's not enough. I need more options than that. But they're ones that they're so cute and novel that they will entertain me for years to come, and they weren't that expensive, so that's how I'm justifying it. And they're decor also, because, like, when you live in, we live in a small house, so things need to be functional if you want to decorate. So yeah, and then hopefully I can run to a craft store and find some more garland and just, like, little green things I can pop everywhere, and then I think I will be complete. And then we just need to vacuum and dust all the things and move a few more things around so we can fit the tree, and that'll be it. I'll do my best to show you, share the process. So the question is, I guess it's not really a question, it's a lot of product, but people probably can't pick it up until after the holiday, and that's like almost 2 weeks from now. So do I leave it in my car, or where am I going to store all this in my house? That's what I get to decide now. This is where we keep the coffee stuff. It's really the only place it fits, because while it's beautiful, that Smeg coffee grinder is really tall and doesn't fit underneath our cupboards, to my knowledge. Now that I've said that, I'm gonna try it one more time, because if it does, I'm gonna put it in this corner over here, but it probably doesn't. So
this is where the coffee goes. And I want our coffee situation to be part of the decor because we use it every day. I think it will just make me happy. And that's usually all I'm going for with our decorations. And yes, it's our little counter compost bin. But anyway, this is the before shot. Adult when I guess not an adult, you're just a certain kind of somebody where you've reached a certain season of your life, let's put it that way, you've reached a certain season of your life when making a little coffee hot chocolate situation for the holidays like brings you so much joy, and all you want to do is stay home on a Friday night and continue working on all of the little cleanup organizational projects that are just brewing in your brain. But you can't because you need to drink some water. I've not had enough water today. And then you need to go pick up your kid from school. And not that I don't want to see my darling child and go have fun with her this evening. But I'm a human too, have wants, needs, and desires. And yeah, I would really love to stay home and clean out her little play kitchen, move it up to her room, keep vacuuming, dusting, and putting things away. I'm just, I'm in the mood. It doesn't always happen, but I'll just have to trust the process. I just have to trust the process that it's all gonna get done and it's gonna be great and that it will get done. It's not like I have a ton planned for this weekend. You know, so it will get done. Hopefully nobody loses it because I'm moving the house around. But yeah, I really am so thrilled that I made that happen, like on a budget without doing anything too crazy. But like it's here now, and like there's the coffee and there's the hot cocoa and there's all our cute mugs and there's more cute mugs over there. And maybe I'll just have to do like a roundup. That would be a good social media thing, right? Just a roundup of the holiday drinkware that we have at our disposal. We have mugs, we have juice glasses. Yeah, I have some favorites. I should share those. I should share my favorites. Because that's it, it's just mugs and other glasses that can double for juice or iced coffee, not like alcohol glasses. I don't really think you need to swap those out for the seasons. I think glass is timeless, glass is seasonless. All right, enough about drinkware. I'm gonna go hydrate. Maybe I can vacuum one more thing, but then I gotta go get the kid, take her to the playground, even though she's gonna wear herself out at Chuck E. Cheese later. But it's just, that's our ritual, and it's a cute one because it's outside and her friends are usually there and it's still fall and nice out, so we gotta enjoy it while we can. You're watching this, take this as a sign to take a big old sip of water, okay?
Saturday. My period started this morning, which is not a bad thing. That's a good thing. And it's, my period's also not that bad. It just means that I'm in that like zen brain space where like all that urgency I felt yesterday to like get all the things done is gone. It's mostly gone. I still have the desire, but we're just gonna get some things done at a slower pace today. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say, slower pace. So I'm gonna jump in the shower, wash my hair, just rinse it all off. And then we're gonna try to get outside today. I'm expecting a very exciting delivery. Yeah, it's gonna be a good day. And I'm trying to finish a book this weekend. I did finish God Killer. I will follow up about that. But I started a study in Drowning this morning, and I would really like to see if I could push myself to finish it this weekend. We'll see. Might not happen, but I'm gonna give it a shot because there are a few other books that I would also like to read before the end of this month, and that is rapidly, rapidly approaching. Later in the day, as you could see my little clip, we did make it outside today. We got to go meet one of my daughter's friends at the playground. I got to chat with their mom, so that was fun. That's always nice when you get to hang out with like another mom. But it was sunny but windy today, so we were out for a little bit, but it was really nice just to get some fresh air and some, you know, sunshine in our eyeballs and on our skin. And then it wasn't too long after we got home that my special delivery that I alluded to arrived. And that is that I got a new, I don't know how well you can see it, but I got a new computer today. It was time. My old laptop was more than 6 years old and it was slowly but surely falling apart. And while I say it's new, it is actually not brand new, but it is new to me. Because based off of what I have learned is going on in the world, particularly in Congo, the DRC, it was really important to me to not buy a brand new electronic. We gotta do what we can. It's still fairly new. Like it was literally just an open box situation that I was able to find. I did look for a refurbished one, but so far I hadn't been able to find one that fit my needs, but I found this one. Not brand new, but brand new to me. And basically it looks like it's honestly never been used before. I did not get to peel the plastic off of the screen. You know, like if you've ever bought a new laptop before, that was gone, but there's no damage on it. But the charging cord and the brick were both in their original packaging, and no one had ever opened the like little document booklet packet thing that came with the computer. So far so good. So I feel good. I needed a new computer. I use it for work. I use it for our life, all the things. But I'm really glad I was able to find one that wasn't necessarily brand new. It was one that somebody else didn't want. So I don't know what they were going to do with it. But I didn't buy it brand new. And that felt really good. And I did finish God Killer yesterday. I think I mentioned that. It was really good. Really good. Like, can't wait for the next one. I'm going to recommend that one to anybody who needs like a good just solid fantasy read. It was really no nonsense. You are just immediately thrown into this situation, and I really appreciated that. Like it wasn't a very complicated setup.
there's intrigue, there's drama, you know, there's a kingdom on the verge of war, and basically you're following these four main characters who, because of a series of just events, unrelated events, somehow all end up on a quest to get to this place that they all need to get to. And of course they all, you know, relationships develop, and then when they finally get to this place, like, more drama happens, and the quest is not as simple as any of them thought. And now, you know, it's very good setup for book 2 and 3, because from what I understand, it is a trilogy that I will be very excited to read when it continues. So I really recommend God Killer if you haven't read it yet and you need just like a straightforward good fantasy story. Like, it was just solid. It was solid, and it was like no nonsense, which I really appreciated. So now I have moved on to A Study in Drowning by Ava Reed. I got this one from our library, so that's why I'm prioritizing this one next. Already I'm only about 44 pages in, but I am really liking it so far. I have no idea where it's going to go, because again, it's a really quick setup. You're just immediately thrown into Effie's world, and you're already starting to get like little glimpses into her history. But she's already kind of like left her familiar area and is kind of sent herself into this new situation, and you have no idea what's going to happen at this point, but you're intrigued. That's how I feel. So I'm going to keep reading this. I had a very lofty goal of thinking that I could read this whole book this weekend. The words are just not getting in my brain as fast as they do other times, so I don't think that's going to happen, but I do plan on continuing to read this tonight, in addition to playing with my new computer that I'm already trying to edit and put the footage together for this here vlog that you are now watching, which is super fun because my old computer wouldn't have played very nicely when I tried to do that, which when I was thinking of trying to start that process today, I got even more excited about the new computer because I realized my old computer, that would have been so painful to try to do that on that computer. Not that I couldn't have done it on my phone, but I'd rather not, because then my hands hurt and it's squinting a lot, and yeah. So anyway, it's gonna be a good time. And I did not get to much more of the kind of organizing, like resetting for the holiday stuff that I had on my brain this morning, but it's only Saturday. Tomorrow's Sunday. Hopefully I can get to more of it then. Yeah, you know, like I told you, the urgency from yesterday went poof when my period arrived, which is okay. That's just part of cyclical living. I know the important things will still get done. The desire will still be there, like I said, but I don't need to beat myself up. That's what understanding your cyclical nature means. You're able to give yourself a lot more grace. A lot more grace. And that's what we're here for. So I'm gonna go. Bath time will be over soon. My presence will be requested. I'm sure my family think I'm crazy because they can hear me talking to my phone. But that's all right. That is all right.
morning. It's Sunday. We're doing the Sunday things. We're having like a slightly fancier breakfast, even though we didn't time it well at all. Or realize that I probably should have defrosted it before today, but we're gonna give it a shot. I found these biscuits and gravy set at Costco the other day, and I really wanna eat it. But anyway, we're just trying to, basically it's some biscuits and you're supposed to bake them and then you warm up the gravy. We're trying to bake the biscuits from frozen. None of that's really important to you, but that's where I'm at today. You know, we're doing the laundry. I'm about to change into other comfy clothes because it's Sunday. And if there is a day for just a coordinated comfy set, it is Sunday, right? So I'm gonna try this new one that I had gotten, I don't know, a few weeks ago, and I just haven't decided to put it on yet. It's all green, so I'm very excited to wear that because that's my favorite color. Fun fact. Yeah, and then we're just gonna relax. Gonna do some more organizing and cleaning, just a little bit. I'm gonna walk up to our local co-op grocery store because one, I love that grocery store, and two, it's the closest one and I can walk there. Pick up a couple essentials to get us through today and into the week, even though it is a holiday week, so you don't need quite as much stuff. We just need the essentials. But I want to get it done sooner rather than later, so then hopefully I don't have to leave the house again today.
Something menacing, we both learn.
I am going to finish this book this weekend after all. Just, I can't put it down. I can't stop. The pacing is really, really good, where you just want to keep going because stuff keeps happening. But anyway, I need to pause now. I have less than 100 pages left, but I have to make dinner. We gotta eat. So I'm gonna do that, but with any luck, I will have some time tonight and I can wrap this one up and find out how it ends.
Hit. You hit my crowbar.